I'm originally from Canton, Ohio. Our lab focuses on the bacterium Francisella tularensis, which is designated as a Tier 1 select agent by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. However, Francisella is also a tick-borne disease, which is the research focus of my project.
I'm from Rhode Island. My research focus is on the complement system, which is a really important part of the immune system, and we study what makes the complement work well in disease.
I'm originally from India, but I've been here for a while now. I did my master's here, then I worked for 2 years, and now I'm doing my PhD. And I work on the complement system, which is a part of the innate immune system. My work really revolves around two proteins, propidin and factor H, which are the regulators of the complement system.
The Huntley Lab developed a mouse tick F. tularensis infection model to study how this bacterium interacts with ticks. But I also use a lot of wet lab techniques, including recombinant protein, cloning, and making mutants.
I use a lot of immunology techniques. I use ELISAs, which are a way of studying if a protein is present in something like blood. I do those most of the time. I also get to do something really cool, which is called HPLC, where I put protein through an instrument in order to separate it by its size.
On a daily basis, I mainly use ELISAs. And then I do a lot of cell culture techniques also, and sometimes I do flow cytometry. But it's basically ELISAs and cell culture techniques that I focus on daily.
Usually I spend about 8 to 9 hours a day during the week, and depending on my workload, I'll spend 1 to 2 days over the weekend focusing on my research project or compiling data.
My normal day in the lab would entail doing experiments, which some of my experiments can take minimum 6 hours, and some of them can take 8 hours because there's just a lot of steps involved. So you may do one step of your experiment and you can leave it alone for an hour. So during that hour, I'll use my time to maybe prepare for tomorrow's experiment or do lab maintenance, or then I might read a research paper relevant to my research or prepare for a course. So there's always something that I'm doing. I'm usually doing many things at once during my day in the lab.
There are times where we have a lot of experiments back to back. So, and there are times where the time is also not so hectic. So typically I put in 8 to 9 hours of work, but it depends on which side of the experiments that I am on.
To balance my personal and professional life, I usually try and get a lot of work done during the week and try and be as efficient as possible so that I can leave my weekends open to catch up on different things or go home and see friends and family.
What I mainly do is that I try to arrange my work schedule such a way that I can get one full day of work so that I can do something for myself and spend time with my friends and family. So that's what I do.
I make sure that I take breaks, because if you don't, you will lose your mind. So I feel I give myself the opportunity to take breaks, and I like to volunteer in my community. We have a really fantastic art museum here in Toledo. So on the weekends, I get to volunteer there, and that gives me a nice opportunity to take a break from school.
I especially like the tunnel that is, like, there's a tunnel that connects the building to the library, which is actually made of full of glass. And I especially like it during winter and fall. I think the view is really good. So I really like to take a walk sometimes there, which helps me unwind.
Yeah, there's an alumni room in the basement of the Mulford Library, and they have a ping pong table, they have a pool table down there, and it's just a good place to relax and hang out with friends, either during lunch or on the weekends.
Yeah, I really like the courtyard outside of HEB. There's some really nice tables that you can enjoy a meal there, especially when the weather's nice. It's a great place to unwind and have lunch.
The COVID-19 pandemic was difficult because I have a lot of long-term research projects, but luckily my advisor, Dr. Huntley, was really helpful in getting in the lab and helping me out with some of these different techniques.
So in the beginning, it was really tricky when labs were closed. Luckily, I found work that I could do from home, so I was able to continue with my research. Now we're pretty much back to normal, so I'm really grateful for that and moving forward every day.
I think it has been a difficult time for all of us. Personally, in work-wise, I think it has delayed my progress a little bit, but now I think we are all back on track.
For someone considering the University of Toledo, I think it's helpful because you get a lot of individual support from different professors. And it's also helpful being on a medical campus because all these departments are so clinically focused on their research that it really helps our research be translational into the field.
One of the great things about Toledo is the mentorship that you have here. The professors are dedicated to giving you the best experience possible. They will go out of their way so that you have a good experience. And I think that's been really beneficial for me. And I've learned a lot from my mentor that's made me a better student and also probably a mentor in the future.
The university is not big, which someone considers as a disadvantage, but I personally consider it as an advantage because I think there is good research going on in Toledo. And it's not so big enough that you don't get the focus that you won't get in big universities. So if you know what you want and if you know what kind of field that you want to work in and if you find a good mentor, I think this is really a good place for you to develop yourself professionally. I'm really happy that I chose University of Toledo to do my PhD program.
I'm happy with my decision to come to the University of Toledo.
Yes, I'm very happy with my decision to attend the University of Toledo. There are many reasons, but the number one is probably the people here. I've met the best of friends at Toledo that I couldn't get anywhere else.